Welcome to My Brain Pacer. Through this app, you can plan and pace your activities in order to manage symptoms from your concussion, also known as a mild traumatic brain injury. Its built-in points program helps you plan your days so you can set limits to the number of activities that you participate in and manage your symptoms. Before you can begin to use the app, you will need to register. Once you have verified your account, you can log into the app. You will then be asked to answer questions about your current symptoms and quality of life. When you have finished answering the questions, you will be brought to the app homepage. Keep in mind that the app homepage can always be accessed from the menu on the left-hand side. In the calendar section, you can input your daily activities and their point values. Your goal is to stay within your daily point limit so your brain can recover. In the My Data section, you will see how many points you have used each day. It will also show when you have exceeded your limit. This can help you determine when you have done too much. In the Notes section, this is a great place to keep lists or reminders. This can include grocery lists or activities you plan to do, like going to the bank. The Frequently Asked Questions section has information on how the app works. You can also visit the Tips and Tricks section to learn strategies for symptom management. We will now show you how to add and track your activity. Now we're going to add an activity into the daily schedule. First, click on the calendar icon from the home page. To add an activity, you simply tap on the blue Add button in the top right-hand corner. As you can see, the default date for this activity is today. I'm going to type in using the computer as my activity that I'm going to choose for today. As you can see, using the computer is programmed into the app already. And you can simply click on the autocomplete to choose that task. I will then add a start time. The start time for today's activity will be 10 o'clock. The default time for all activities in the app is half an hour. You can see here that using the computer defaults to 3 activity points. This value is based on what previous users have experienced. Your level of difficulty and symptoms may be different. You now have the option of adjusting the point value. When you click on the blue change button, you can now rate how difficult the activity is for you on a scale of 0 to 10. 0 means the activity is very easy to complete, and 10 means it is very hard to complete. The average difficulty rating for computer time on the app by default is a 4, but you may feel it is a little more difficult for you. For example, you may say it's a 6 out of 10. In this case, slide the scale until it reads 6 out of 10. Next, you'll want to add your symptom level. This is also rated on a 0 to 10 scale. 0 means you have no symptoms at all when you participate in this task. 10 means you have the worst symptoms ever. The average symptom rating for computer time is 8. If you agree with this rating, you will leave the scale at 8 out of 10. The app then calculates the activity points based on your difficulty and symptom ratings. So based on these adjustments, the activity is now rated at a 3.5. When you click on the Save button, it will also remember that you've adjusted this in the past and keep it for future activities when you enter them in. You can now click on the blue Save button at the very bottom to save this activity into your calendar. Once you have saved the activity, it will now show up in your calendar. If you have completed the activity, you can click on the little blue checkmark box. If you click on the task itself, you can also record any symptoms that you experienced when you were doing the task. For example, you may say that your time on the computer caused you to have a headache. You can rate the intensity of your symptoms on a scale of 0 to 10. 0 means you have no symptoms at all. 10 means you have the worst symptoms ever. For example, you may say your headache was not the worst you've ever had, but it was still very painful and bothersome, so you rate it at a 7. You can also add how long the symptoms lasted. For example, if your headache developed while you were on the computer and lasted for just under about 30 minutes, you can choose this as an option. Since this was the only symptom you had at this time, you can exit the symptom screen. Now you can check that the activity is complete. If you want to add an activity that's not pre-programmed into the app, you can do this as well. Click on the blue Add button again. This time I'm going to add an activity that is not programmed into the app itself, and I'm going to program in washing the car. I'm going to add a start time to this for today. I'm going to do this maybe at 2 o'clock this afternoon. And it probably will take me longer than a half an hour. So I'm going to say it's going to take me till 3 o'clock this afternoon to finish. As you can see, the activity points is 0 because it is not included in the app already. So you will need to manually add in the point values for this task. For washing the car, your difficulty level may be a 3. But perhaps it gives you a raging headache afterwards, and you know this ahead of time. So I'm going to say that the symptom aggravation is very high, maybe a 10. So this will default to a 3.25 point value for washing the car. And I'm going to hit save. Now when I hit save and it goes back to the calendar app, I can see washing the car is 3.25. You can also see from the main calendar page that the app is keeping a tally of how many points you have used today. So as of right now, I have used 9.25 of my 17 points that I have allotted for today's tasks. Sometimes when you add an app in, it will also give you a pop-up screen that has some tips and tricks. If you don't like this, you can always override this and turn it off in the settings component. You could now go to the My Data section to review your daily point values over various weeks. You can see the total number of points you have used each day. The solid black line shows what your daily point value maximum is. Days that you have used too many points will have a red bar. This can be helpful if you experience delayed symptoms. You are now ready to start pacing and planning your daily activities using this app. If you have any further questions, be sure to explore the About section. Thank you.